The shimmering golden wrath of the heavens made flesh. Paladins deal merciless justice to the sworn enemies of order. In this video, we're going to show how to paint one of these models. We're going to be painting it in the colour scheme of the Hammers of Sigma. Now, we're going to be following the contrast method and painting up to battle ready. But the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model. Now, as you can see here, I've used grey sear, which is perfect for all the contrast paints we're going to be applying. Now, we're going to start with the armour. We're going to be painting this with Nazdreg yellow. So I'm just going to give the pot a quick shake. Get that popped open like so. Now I'll use a medium shade brush for this, and I'm going to coat it over all the armour. So all I'm going to do is just apply a little bit to my palette. This is not to thin it down or anything, it's just so I don't overload my brush too much. And all I'm going to start doing is then just painting that all over the armour. In some places, you'll obviously be going over areas that will be different colours. Once the Nazdreg yellow is dry, just reapply grey sear to those areas. There we are with the gold armor now picked out and any other details tidied back up with grey sear. We're ready to move on to the next step, which is to apply some more contrast paints. Now we're going to start first with the shoulder pauldrons and the trim of the tabard, and for this we'll be using Leviathan Blue. After that, for the parchment, we'll use Skeleton Horde. For the white lightning bolts on his symbol, we'll be using Apothecary White. And for the metals, or the silver areas, we'll be using Griff Charger Grey. But first of all, let's start with Leviathan Blue. So I'm just going to use a small layer brush for this. Apply a little bit to the palette like so. This is not really to thin it down, it's just so I don't overload the brushing, also just to get it to a nice point as well. And all we're going to do is then start applying that actually onto the shoulder pauldrons like so, and don't forget the tabard as well. And if you do make any mistakes, like splodging onto the yellow, just tidy back up with grey sear and reapply Nazdreg yellow. With all those blue details picked out, we're now going to move on to the parchment. For this, we're using Skeleton Horde. With the parchment done, we're now going to move on to any white details, and we'll be using Apothecary White for that. With the white details picked out, what we're going to do now is use Griff Charger Grey for any metallic silver details. There we are with the silver details now picked out. What we're going to do now is move on to applying the rest of the contrast paint. So first of all, we're going to start a Black Templar for any black leather details, such as the belt and the armor joints. After that, for his plume, we're going to use Blood Angel Red. We're going to finish off by painting the weapon haft with Volupus Pink. But first of all, let's start with the black details. So all I'm going to do is just apply a little bit to the palette. Again, this is not to thin it down. This is just to get a nice point to my brush and make sure I don't overload it as well. Now what I'm going to do is start doing the soft joints between the armour, so just around the back here. Now I've left these Nazdreg yellow because actually once you start putting the Black Templar on, you're not going to really see any of that yellow shown through anyway. So you don't really need to go through and tidy that up with grey sear. Just apply it straight over like I'm doing here. With those black leather areas now done, we're going to move on to the plume and we're coating this in Blood Angel's Red. With his plume now picked out, we're just going to finish off by painting the weapon haft with Volupus Pink. There we are with the weapon haft now done. We're ready to move on to the next step, which is to apply some texture. Now for this, we'll be using Aglin Badlands. So I'm going to grab my trusty texture tool. Now I'll be using the large scoop first, just to scoop a load out of the tub like so. And all I'm going to do is then just dollop that onto the base like so. So once that's all on, like there, I'm going to move around to the smaller section, or smaller part, just to be a bit more accurate around those feet. Now you just need to cover the whole base in this, give it about an hour to dry, and then paint the rim of the base in a colour that matches your army. For this one, we're going to be using Steel Legion Drab. There we are, with the texture now dry and the rim of the base painted, our Stormcast Paladin is battle ready. Now there are a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when using contrast paints, it's easy to start with the armour first and pick all the other details later on, as we did in this video. And also when using contrast paints, try not to overload your brushes, it can quickly run out of control. If you do find this happening, just use your brush to soak up any excess. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own battle-ready paladins. We'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.